and today we're going to talk about worms. Have you ever wondered what worms are up to? What are they eating? How do they move? What are they doing all day? These are the questions that keep me up at night. You too? Oh, no? Okay. Anyways, today we're going to talk about worms, specifically vermicomposting. Vermicomposting is a process of using worms and microorganisms to convert organic matter into nutrient-rich humus. Basically, that means worms and microorganisms are just eating organic matter. What's that? What'd you say? What's organic matter? You ask all the right questions. Organic matter is something that has recently come from a living organism, like plants or animals. Organic matter can be broken down. So, like, for example, when you see a dead plant or leaf and it starts to break down and it shrivels up, that's an example of it decaying. Worms help speed up this process of decay. So vermicomposting is the process of worms acting as decomposers to break down organic material that we might normally throw away. Let's take a closer look. This bin was donated to our office around 2 years ago, and I volunteered to maintain it for my programming. And so I'm not a vermicomposting expert. It has been a lot of learning by doing, which we like to do in 4-H. But this is a stackable system. It's for upward migration. But that's not what all worm bins look like. It's pretty easy to make your own at home. And we'll show you some resources later that can help you with that. I'm sure you've seen earthworms when you've been outside playing. But not all earthworms are good for vermicomposting bins. Do you know there are over 9,000 species of earthworms? I don't know exactly how many I have in my bin. I know I have red wigglers. So red wigglers are the most commonly used kind for vermicomposting. But I know that they're reproducing pretty quickly because I can find worm eggs or tiny little baby worms like this one. The bottom layer is called the working layer. And so this is where I've been putting all of my food scraps and compostable trash. So my coffee grounds have been going in here. I've been putting pieces of paper bags in here and newspapers and things like that. You can still see there are some eggshells, but these worms have been hard at work. Soon, this will be ready to be put in my garden. The whole point of vermicomposting is for worms to eat our compostable trash. But how do they do that? I don't see a mouth or teeth. Turns out they do have a tiny mouth, but no teeth. Instead, their throat reaches out and grabs microorganisms and organic matter and pulls it back into its mouth. Some of the food is passed into the bloodstream and used by the earthworm. The rest makes castings or worm poop. Ew, gross. Just kidding. That's what we like about worms. Now, I know what you're thinking. Miss Morgan, we get it. Worms are cool. But why should we care? There are a few very important reasons. Castings, or worm poop, help water and air permeate the soil. When added to the soil, castings boost the available nutrients to the plants, which help plants grow. It is estimated that around 60% of the waste in the U.S. is actually organic material, things like paper products and food scraps. If we vermicomposted these things instead of throwing them in the landfill, it will reduce methane generation in landfills and ultimately reduce greenhouse gases. To recap, vermicomposting, whether at homes or at schools, is not only good for our soil, but good for the environment. Thanks, worms! To learn more about vermicomposting, we go right on over to this website by Ms. Rhonda Sherman, where you'll find all the information I presented today and more. Thanks!